Good afternoon. It started as a peaceful nighttime prayer service and ended in terror. A Christian leader stabbed multiple times by a 16-year-old boy while giving a sermon at the altar of Christ, the Good Shepherd Church in Wakeley in our west. The entire incident streamed online. Police arrested the teen at the scene but were very quickly forced to take shelter with paramedics as a crowd of more than 500 people swarmed the church, attacking police and rioting in the surrounding streets. The attack prompting the New South Wales Police Commissioner to declare the event an act of terror.
At 1:35 a.m. this morning, after consideration of all the material, I declared that it was a terrorist incident. Strike Force Katrina has been established to investigate that side of the events last night.
Our reporter Alex Heinke was right there as the riot squads moved in. He followed them as they worked to bring the highly volatile situation under control.
What we're going to be seeing here is heavily armed police. These guys' missions is to get into this church. What they're going to be doing is coming through here. If you look around to your shoulder, this is a strong police presence. There might be 50 to 60 officers here. They'll be moving to allow these vehicles in. There's still a lot of people further down the road. What we're seeing right now is police in that very strong line. They are pushing this crowd back. You can see here, tensions are just starting to flare. We've got more police behind right now as they move in to try and pull this man out of the church.
Get back!
Get back!
Here they go again. They're moving further down the street now. We've just seen a man get pepper sprayed just here. This man here has just been pepper sprayed. Pepper spray is being used as authorities continue to move people back.
I just got pepper sprayed. They came in force. They started hitting us with the batons. Yep. They pepper sprayed us.
When you heard about what happened, what was going through your mind?
Just sadness, man, to be honest, sadness. It's one of our main priests as well. It's upsetting.
What we've just seen there is the person that was trapped inside the church has now been whisked away. There was a police escort in front of them and the ambulance followed behind. We're seeing some more vehicles now leave as that police line behind us remains strong. If you're just coming with me in here, this is maybe the third or fourth at least police vehicle that we've spotted. And just have a look at some of the damage. You can see there's glass inside. That whole window has been smashed in the back as well. Just watch your feet because we've got glass inside. We've got glass on the ground. There are several police vehicles that appear to have been smashed, to have been hit by this crowd, this mob that was coming through the streets, being eventually pushed back by authorities. There would have to be at least 40 to 50 police cars here. Many of them, there's like this one, are damaged. So what we have here is this line of heavily armed police. They have been going through the streets and clearing everyone that doesn't live here. If you just see beyond this police line, that is the group that is of concern right now. They have been hurling abuse. You can see they're covering their faces as well, almost trying to taunt police into moving forward on them. And these officers here, they are really pushing through, trying to clear out these streets and eliminate that threat as quickly as possible. It looks like the crowd over that side of the road is calming down. Things are de-escalating a little bit. They have pushed back, although the taunts are still coming. We just heard over the police radios as well, just to be wary and I guess just to look out for any projectiles that these people might be throwing. But at this stage, the standoff is very much on. So police have just moved up one last time. We're just going to watch our feet here. Look at them. They're on the street now. This is one of the main roads through this suburb. And they are clearing out everyone. There are cars still on the road. Here comes a police officer down the sidewalk. More officers jumping out from there. There is a vehicle here we're just going to watch out for. But what they're doing is pushing this group further and further back, trying to disperse them. We're going to go and take a closer look. You can see that the riot squad have shut down one of these main roads. There is traffic, civilians in those vehicles. Some of them are turning around and simply driving the other way. They are going to be moving back down in a second. They've just opened up, and they're going to let some of this traffic through.
Riot 18.
Well, we've made it to the church, which is really the epicentre of this event. I just want to show you some of the damage that we've seen. This is just one police car that has been smashed, the back there and the side windows as well, the panels beaten. Have a look at the damage to the front as well. We've seen bricks on the street, we've seen logs. It seems like they were using really anything they could get their hands on. There's more windows being smashed at the front, big chips out of this vehicle. We've just seen the police dog now being deployed just up the road there, and obviously still a very heavy police presence at the church. There are ambulances inside, there are dozens and dozens of police officers as well. The road really is a mess. There's rocks, there's pebbles, there's glass. This is an incredible scene. Another police vehicle just parked up in driveways. We've lost count of how many police vehicles we've seen. This was a huge response, and right there, here it is. We're basically at the church where all of this started.
Erin Ramsey is outside the church in Wakeley, where leaders and locals are trying to calm community tensions.
The Christ the Good Shepherd Church here in Wakeley in Sydney's West still very much remains an active crime scene. Detectives and forensic teams still collecting evidence. Meanwhile, the community is still reeling from the chaos that erupted here last night. Members of the church, first and foremost, concerned about the welfare of Bishop Marmari Emmanuel. Many stopping by today to lay flowers or say a prayer.
He's my idol. This church here works very hard to make people live in peace, not in a war.
This all in response to the knife attack inside the church last night, now declared a terrorist attack by New South Wales police. It's understood the 53-year-old religious leader was conducting a Bible preaching session here around 7 when he was allegedly attacked by a 16-year-old boy holding a knife.
We just heard people started screaming, running out from the church. I was shaking, and even till now.
My grandma and my auntie started screaming, and I'm like, what's happening? And I look up and there's something going on the screen, and all of a sudden the live stream cuts off. It was terrifying.
Members of the church rushing in to restrain that teenager and tend to the bishop. It's understood 39-year-old Father Isaac Royel, another member of the congregation, was also injured in the altercation. Meanwhile, words quickly circled about the attack on social media, causing a large mob of hundreds to form outside the church, making it difficult for police to enter. Those inside trapped with the bishop and the alleged attacker. The riot squad called in as the mob of thousands became destructive, smashing police cars and breaking fences, police resorting to using pepper spray to try and subdue the crowd.
There were thousands of people, hundreds of police and riot squad.
Disastrous, yeah. In a world that we're living in, or what happened in Bondi, the hate that's in this world is taking an enormous toll on everyone.
It doesn't feel safe at all. We are scared. I'm scared. My kids are scared.
The bishop and priest were eventually taken to hospital, where they remain in a stable condition, but it took police hours before they could escort out the teenage offender due to the crowd. He was taken to hospital, where he remains under police guard and has been formally arrested. His parents today seen leaving their home in Sydney southwest. The scale and escalation of this situation has leaders talking, both the Prime Minister and New South Wales Premier making it clear this morning that this behaviour will not be tolerated in Australia.
This is a disturbing incident. There is no place for violence in our community. There is no place for violent extremism.
I want to make something very, very clear. There is no such thing in Australia in taking the law into your own hands. It doesn't exist.
Counter-terrorism groups have now joined the large-scale investigation, including into whether the 16-year-old had any links to terrorist groups.
Following the attack, the United States has issued a travel alert for Australia. Claudia Vodoljak is at the US Embassy in Canberra. Claudia, what's the advice?
Well, Kate, this isn't an upgraded travel warning or cause for serious alarm, but rather the embassy is urging US citizens in Australia to be extra careful, to avoid demonstrations and areas with significant police activity. The alert was issued within the last day. It reads, in the aftermath of the horrific incident at Bondi Junction, the US mission to Australia is reminding citizens to remain vigilant, be aware of surroundings and practice personal security. Going on to say, as this incident showed, dangerous events can occur in the most unexpected of areas. Those visiting popular tourist places should pay extra attention to their surroundings. Australia is right now dealing with two highly distressing events that have not only shocked us as a nation, but clearly left an impression on the world. Today, the Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese, acknowledged the sense of unease and concern people are feeling. But Kate, he's reassuring that the public, that authorities are doing their jobs.
Claudia, thank you.